Hi, this is Peter Stanley here. Tonight I'm going to show an easy way to start seeds using the Kratky method, and also a way to transplant the seedlings as well, using the same, basically the same thing. So what I use are these Park Seed Biodome sponges. And you don't have to use these, I just have a bunch of them. And also, this is kind of a trick. If you use the AeroGarden baskets, any kind of bottle that has a 1.5 inch opening will fit these. Like I've been using these packed fruit juice. I've been drinking a lot of these. And the AeroGarden basket fits right in there perfectly. It'll also fit into a gallon milk jug or water jug. I think you can get, I'm pretty sure you can get 1.5 inch net pots that probably fit just as well. I haven't tried them, but you can also use like 2 inch net pots and cut your bottle down, cut this off to the level where this would seat in there. And then use something like a rapid rooter plug or root rod or any of those. Or you could use some rock wool. So anyway, what I'm going to do is first show how to start seeds, and what I'm going to do first is get my solution in my bottle, and I'm using some pre-mixed MasterBlend, and this is my seed starting strength. I'll put in the description the exact measurements I'm using. So let me step up here and pour this in here, and I usually use the I kind of pre-fill it, then I use the basket as kind of a to know where to stop filling. I'll go ahead and plug that in. Let's see. Ooh, too much. And just a second, let me pour some of this off. I'll be right back. Sorry about that. So, let's see, so I'm going to add a little bit more back in here. That's about where I want it. Basically, I want it to be just a little ways up to the bottom, and it's going to wick the solution up. And, let's stick these in here. I'm going to go ahead and put my seeds in here first. I usually do 2 or 3 seeds. Usually they'll all germinate, or most will. And then you just clip or transplant out the ones you don't want. So I push it in about that far, and then drop it in here. You can see that the solution's coming up to about there. That's probably fine. And that's all I do. I'll say, I usually make aluminum foil lid on these just to block the light. This will swell up a little bit and kind of fill this out. So not too worried about it, but I usually just wrap the whole bottle in aluminum foil. Also, I was thinking about using some of this. I was going to throw it away, but it was like a bag that had a bunch of little bitty pretzel bags. But I was thinking that I could just wrap some of that around it, because aluminum foil is kind of expensive. I probably should have done that before I filled the bottle, but I could still go back and add that. It's no big deal. The second thing I want to demonstrate is how to transplant, and use the same exact method. So basically, again, you could do this with whatever, but just what I use. So this has a little hole in the top, and this doesn't go all the way through, but it kind of gives you a starting point to just take some scissors and just kind of force it down in there. So you can see how that kind of spreads apart. So what I would do is take the sprout, open this up a little bit, lay the sprout down in there, and fold it up, stick it in the net pot. So I don't have a pepper sprout, but I actually got some microgreens that, and I don't even remember what these are, but just for demonstration purposes, I'm going to use one of these. I actually grow it out too, just to see what happens. So I use this. It's got a little. There's the root there. Let's see it better here. A little bit of a seed case on there too. I think this might be broccoli, but I'm not sure. So plan this layout too well, but. So it kind of fits in there. And let's stick this. It's got on the inside where it's middle. It'll straighten up when it starts to grow. Get some white on it. Anyway, so that's how to do that. And as far as labeling these, I usually just use some masking tape right on the side where it is and the date. But you know, I'll do that in a minute. Yeah, it is a good idea to cover these too to keep algae out. But I wanted to show you some that already been growing. This is a blue Christmas chili that I started with the Kratky method. I mean, I just put the seed, started the seed in here. And I think I put the seed in there on January 11th, and it's February 12th today, so just right at a month. And from seed to here, it's just been catching sunlight from AeroGarden. And these are some extras that I just put into sprouts, and they're growing really well. As you can see, some roots. All that's new growth. All right, hope you like that. So that was the it's an easy way to start seeds or transplant sprouts using the Kratky method and just using some stuff I have laying around the house. And hope you like that. Thanks for watching, and please like, comment, and subscribe.